Federal magistrate today found there is probable cause for the government to prosecute an Army veteran charged with promoting international sex tours for pedophiles. WESH News' Bob Kaling was in the courtroom today and joins us live right now with more. And Bob, the suspect's attorney argued for the government to free him?
Yeah, that's right, Martha, but the judge was hearing none of that. In fact, a couple of rulings he made here today mean, number one, that the government's case against this suspected sex trafficker will continue and that he'll remain in jail indefinitely until there's some resolution of this case. The prosecution team argued successfully to a federal judge today that 51-year-old Army veteran Patrick Minga believed he was setting up a sex tour for pedophiles based in Rockledge to travel to a small town in Ecuador. That established probable cause to continue with the charge, which could bring him 30 years in prison. WESH 2 legal analyst Alicia Adamson.
I'm not surprised that the judge found that there was probable cause, but you got to realize that probable cause is such a very, very low burden. Children are the most innocent victims, and so I think that when you have cases like this, judges, the state attorney's office, the federal government, everyone is trying to make sure that these people are contained.
Brevard County Sheriff's Major Case Detective Michael Spadafora testified that he answered a Craigslist ad offering South American sex tours to Ecuador with unlimited women. But when he brought up the idea of having sex with young girls, according to testimony, Minga replied that he specialized in taboo and that he was using lollipops to entice young girls to participate. The judge brought up the lollipop comment as an indication Minga was actively involved in enticing children.
And I guarantee you, if this case goes to trial, you're going to hear the lollipop in the opening statement and you'll hear it in the closing argument.
His lawyer then asked that Minga be freed pending his trial, but the judge found him to be too much of a flight risk and potential danger to children. And according to the U.S. State Department, both Central and South America are particular problem areas for this type of sex tourism with underage children, which victimizes in total about 2 million children a year. Reporting outside the federal courthouse in Orlando, Bob Kaling, WESH 2 News.